We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well. Our rowing, crew, and top-ranked bass fishing programs compete out of the Adrian College Boathouse, a gorgeous facility just a 15-minute drive north on Devil's Lake. Our students know how to relax in their downtime. When they're not out and about, we have dozens of housing options on campus. With apartments right in the mix of things, you can pick what works best for you. We've also recently renovated a few of our housing options. Adrian College is a Methodist-affiliated institution that has been changing lives since 1859. The modern liberal arts education offered by our faculty is unrivaled. We can't wait to have you on campus and show you around. Visit adrian.edu to schedule a full campus visit today. We'll see you soon.
We continue to take pride and learn from Asa Mahan's leadership today. 161 years of commitment to harnessing the power of creativity, ingenuity, community, and academic excellence.
I believe that if you get your degree here, the world is going to feel like it's shrinking.
How you're going to walk out of here when it's all said and done. Because the game is going to go on. And there's only one rule you're going to need to know about. There are no second chances. There's only this moment and the next moment. Every one of those moments is a test that you get to take one time and only one time. So if you see an opening, tear into it. If you get a shot at victory, make damn sure you take it. Seize that moment. That moment is a crossroads where everything you want will collide with everything standing in your way. You've got momentum at your back. Fear and doubt are thundering like a freight train straight at you. And all you got, the only difference between making history and being history, the only thing you can count on in any given moment is you. It's you versus them. You versus no. You versus can't. You versus next year, last year, statistics, excuses. It's you versus history. Versus the odds. It's you versus second place. Clock is ticking. Let's see what you've got.
A single thread is unique. Like each of us, full of purpose and potential. A strand designed to connect, strengthen, and unite. But we face different challenges and have different opportunities. By acknowledging that others may struggle in ways we do not, we can celebrate our differences, embrace each other, and fortify the ties among us. A single thread can fray, yet when it's woven with another, a bond forms. A new strength created by the fabric of the whole. Let's embrace the fabric we make together, the diversity of our threads, to reach beyond ourselves and overcome the impossible. The true power of our game comes from unifying our individual backgrounds, connecting our unique stories, enabling us to be stronger, braver, greater. We can achieve so much more when we are all as one.
What a season. The confetti is going to fall. There she goes, and she's got it. How sweet is this, and how wonderful for the sport.
Thank you. crosses over, back onto the far side. Rips a shot, she scores!
Adrian College is a pinpoint like no other. With our 77 undergraduate degrees, 47 majors, and 21 broad fields of study, Adrian has a one-of-a-kind, hands-on learning experience for everyone. Do you want to visit the campus of Adrian College in person? Visit adrian.edu.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the beautiful Arrington Ice Arena for tonight's celebration of the 2022 NCAA Division III National Champions, the Adrian College Bulldogs. Adrian finished the season with a 31-1 record and went on to a 31-game winning streak after dropping the opener to Utica College while missing 12 starters. The Bulldogs set a program record 31 wins in a single season during the 2021-22 season. As a team, Adrian went on to win the NCHA Peters Cup with a perfect 18-0 record in conference and won the 2022 Harris Cup with a 12-3 victory over St. Norbert. Multiple athletes received awards this season. Matt Eller, Sam Ruffin, Alessio Luciani, and Cam Gray were made the All-NCAA team this season. With Matt Kudo being voted to the All-Freshman team. During the NCHA Harris Cup playoffs, Sam Ruffin, Jaden Shields, Terry Ryder, and Cam Gray were all named to the Harris Cup alternate team, with Cam Gray receiving the MVP award. Adrian was also honored for its work in the classroom as 16 Bulldogs were named to the NCHA All-Academic Team with a GPA of 3.3 or higher. Prior to the 2022 Division III Frozen Four, the American Hockey Coaches Association announced its 2021-22 All-Americans naming Matt Eller, Alessio Luciani, and Cam Gray first-team All-Americans, and Sam Ruffin a second-team All-American. After the national championship win, the NCAA named Matt Eller, Trevor Poikendahl, and Cam Gray to the NCAA All-Tournament team, and named Sam Ruffin as the NCAA Tournament MVP. Lastly, head coach Adam Krug was named the NCHA Coach of the Year and winner of the Edward Jeremiah Award for the American Hockey Coaches Association Division III Coach of the Year Award.
Assistant coach Adam Phillips. head coach, Adam Drews.
Yeah. A junior forward from Carmel, Indiana, number 47, Jimmy Thiewa. A junior forward from Cartwright, Manitoba, number 49, Ty Ian. A senior forward from Westfield, Indiana, system captain, number 9,
Division III Coach of the Year Award. And whereas, in addition to their athletic achievements, 16 Bulldogs were also named to the NCAA All-Academic Team with a GPA of 3.3 or higher. And whereas, the team, as well as Adrian College, is a point of pride for the citizens of Adrian. Now, therefore, I, Angela Sorkeith, Mayor of the City of Adrian, Michigan, along with the City Commission and the citizens of Adrian, do hereby congratulate the Adrian College hockey team on their great accomplishments.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, may I present the National Coach of the Year, Adam Crew.
Before I do, we're going to go off script a little bit because our captain was a little bit worried of kind of double-crossing me with some thank yous. So I'm going to bring Matt up here and let him say some words real quick. Matt, come on up here.
Other coaches across the street, Coach Rainey,
way he's been a mentor for me. Coach Shindell, a guy that I was on the hiring staff for, and we knocked it out of the park with him. But to have some conversations with Coach Shindell brings me a long way as a coach, and I appreciate those guys' conversations and friendships. The community, again, the boosters, the Gold Puck Club, you guys are honestly, like, you guys are awesome. As a, as a student athlete, I was fortunate enough to get to know some of you, and coming back as a coach 8 years ago, I became even more fortunate to know you as in my adult life as a professional and understand what you all sacrifice for our players. So thank you guys so much. You're way too kind, and we're glad that we're doing you guys proud. In regard to the community, it's great to see this place as full as it is. On many nights, the odd Saturday afternoon that we're playing at the same time as a Michigan football game could have a tough impact on the crowd. But this year, the crowds were phenomenal. I think we're all ready to move forward post-COVID and enjoy each other's company again. So many faces that we missed for the last couple of years found their way back into the seats this year. And it truly makes a difference. You guys are loud, especially those closer games. It can sometimes help us get over the top and win a game for us. So thank you, and I'm glad that we're able to provide you guys some entertainment. And I think there's a really good appreciation between all parties. The administration, there's so many people who have been part of this. I'm not going to name everybody again, but we absolutely thank you for what you do. And I know there's a lot of administrators in here. People who work across the street in the business office and whatnot, but from the administration standpoint, there's two people that I absolutely have to say thank you to, and that's Coach Duffy. Been here for 44 years, and we finally got you that first NCAA team title. My wife says that they were freshmen together. She was a freshman student. He was a freshman president. Lindsay, my wife, has seen this place built from the ground up. But 17 years ago, Jeff Dahlman made a bet on us. Made a bet on this hockey program. He put in a lot of chips in one basket to build this beautiful facility. And it's paid off as a doc. Let's take a second to soak this in. Pretty special. There's alumni that are here, several of them. Appreciate you guys coming out. I love every one of you. We've had some highs and some lows, but I'll tell you, we're not where we are without some of those highs and some of those lows. We've learned a lot. We've learned a lot from each other. I think you're all killing it in the real world. Right, Yammer? Yeah. And I'm so proud to see you guys starting families of your own. Being awesome people, because that's what this is about. This is special. Winning is special. But when it comes down to it, these guys are here to grow as adults. And I don't make any promises to these guys when we recruit them. I don't promise anything to their parents as far as ice time, how many points they might get, or what line they're going to be on. But I will tell you, the one thing that I can look every parent in the eye and tell them is that when their son leaves here, they're going to be a better human being. And I've gotten countless texts over the last few weeks hearing from alumni just thanking me for their time. And I don't want them to even thank me. I just want them to be appreciative of this family that we have here, the brotherhood that we call it, because it's special. Those guys the guys that set the table, the blood, sweat, the tears that they've shed for this program. This championship, winning it, those guys are really much a part of it. And we thank those guys. So give those guys a round of applause. They love it. In 2011, 15, and 17, we made the Frozen Four. in 2007, 2008, those, that season, and then the 08, 09 season, we weren't able to get an AQ, an automatic qualifier in the tournament, which would have been held in Lake Placid. Those two teams had the ability for sure to win. We didn't, partly due to the opportunity to lack thereof, I guess. And really, I think that the fans that have been here for the duration understand that we were able to bring this thing full circle and kind of close the open-ended part of the circle this week. One, by winning, but two, by doing it in Lake Placid, which has been a place that's been kind of a hindrance for us. We just haven't made it there. And when we won this year, I got a call from Ron Fogarty saying, "Kruger, it's happening this year. It's absolutely happening. It's meant to be in Lake Placid." And sure enough, it happened. Just a few more notes about the fans. You've seen so much. You've witnessed so much greatness in this building. You packed this place back in October 2007 for the first game at Arrington Ice Arena. Still packing it 15 minutes later. We've lost a few people back over the years. Some really good fans, and that should not be forgotten. And I think everybody should take a second for those that know who I'm talking about and appreciate those folks that have lost us, or that we've lost, I'm sorry. This fan base keeps growing every year. I see people that I didn't know were fans. In the last 2 months, I've seen 10 or 20 different people come in the office looking for season tickets for next year already. My kids are growing up, and my son Carter, who most of you know, he's the real mayor of Adrian. He plays travel hockey now, and the Toledo charity group that he plays with, I think there's a couple here even, and those folks have become full-on fans, and I think each year we grow a little bit, and our guys are so great with my son's team and my kids, and it speaks volumes of who these guys are, that my son and his teammates look up to them. But this fan base keeps growing. There's 2,600 people at the championship game at Lake Placid. And I don't know that exact number. Coach Duffy alluded to maybe 250 or 300 or something like that. We got over half the building on our side. And so maybe there was more like 1,000 of you there. It was pretty darn remarkable. But this year, let's talk about this year again. 31 wins. 31. I did not know that we broke the record for the greatest win percentage. That's pretty remarkable, guys. I think when Coach Phillips and I kind of put the finishing touches on the recruiting class this past summer, we knew we had something good. The way we played, the guys that we brought in had some special stuff going on. We trained with the Navy SEALs in the woods back in September. Then we got wiped out by COVID for the opening weekend in Utica, and it felt like the wheels were falling off. Went there with 18 players. There's 30 of them on here today. We can dress 22 on a given night. But we were up against it. We lost on Friday night at Utica. We thought we lost maybe our one chance to sneak one out of there. The next night, the guys, the 16 that were there, figured out a way to dig deep. We were tired. Several of these guys haven't played a game in quite a long time. But we went there with guys that maybe haven't made the lineup in a long time. And that to me is a definition of a team. We went there shorthanded, got it on a win, and that Saturday night, our coaching staff felt like we won our group over. We won these guys. And they were going to buy in, and boy, did they. Go on to the Thanksgiving trip to Hartford. Nice win at Wesleyan, and off to Hartford the next day for a 1-0 win against Trinity College, who was a national ranked power. Cam Gray was only shut out of That's kind of hard to believe, Cam, to be honest with you. Then after Christmas time, we walked the dogs to college into the building. We got off to a 3-0 lead halfway through. Ended up finishing that one off 5-2 win. Then we had to go freeze our tails off outdoors at Winterfest. That seems like so long ago at this point, just with what the group has achieved. But that was a big point for me. That was a big moment. I think with that win and the experience and ripping out the camo jerseys that the guys love so much, that was big for us. Fast forward to February, going to Aurora, playing a national ranked team and an underrated team, a very well coached team. Me being the sixth I've ever been, we won despite my lack of coaching. The guys' preparation pulled through. But I knew this team was more special than I've ever coached. When they were building a wall for me, while I'm thrown up in a garbage can so nobody could see it, embarrassing. The next weekend, beat St. Norbert on home ice 84-62, scored 14 goals in the weekend. And we rolled into the playoffs. Sweep of Lake Forest, a big win versus trying to size, then a complete butt kick into St. Norbert once again. Round of the NCAAs, and once you know, we got to draw in the quarterfinals. 7-4 win that night, one of the better teams that we'd seen all year, gave us quite a lot. They were tough to handle, but our guys scored goals, that's what we do. We got some big save, and made some big plays down the stretch. Finally made it to Lake Placid. That win got us to Lake Placid. And had a little bit of, no pun intended, the turbulence getting there. We pushed off the gate 20 minutes later, back to the gate, saying, hold on, we gotta figure some things out, we got a mechanical issue. And 25 minutes later, then we're off the plane, they said, we've got a plane waiting for you. And then an hour plus later, they realized that there weren't enough seats on the next plane, so we're waiting for that, and it was a tough day. Finally, after what was longer than if we would have just bust out there. We got to practice in Lake Placid. Had a tough day, had a tough practice, but I think it was just with the doctor ordered, because the next day, sun was out, and things felt good. We had a good practice. We appreciated where we were. And then we woke up on Friday morning getting ready to play the Frozen Four. The Augsburg game, I don't think we ever really felt like we couldn't win that one, or we weren't going to win that one. We got the lead, and they made it 2-1 in the third period. But ultimately, our guys pulled through. We got a big goal from a guy that has gotten zero praise so far. He should have been on the all NCAA tournament team. Zach Gobaris with a big goal that night. Through the NCAA tournament. So that was about as hot of a streak as I've seen for one player in a playoff push. Good job, Gopes. Then we got into the final, and it didn't feel real. The entire day didn't feel real. It took forever. The clock was going slower than I swear it's ever gone before. I knew we were going to win. I knew we were. Kind of all day. Could feel my stomach. But what really put that feeling over the top was when players went out on the ice for warm up, I went for a lap because I was a little bit anxious. And there was a black curtain by our locker room. And I poked my head out into this area where the national tournament trophy was. There's an Adrian College trophy, or a jersey, and a Geneseo jersey. And the only person in that room was my wife. And then in come my kids. And just in that moment, I just knew, like, this is happening. So we go back out there, and we're playing very good to start. That first 3 minutes was a little tough. But a big hit, center ice and soon. I thought it looked a little high right from the start. Something weird about the Frozen Four that many of you probably don't know is they allow video replay. And we adopted the Division I college rules where they have all the technology and all the buildings are equipped for it. So you can challenge major penalties. And so plays going on, and we're on the bench, and somebody that hasn't gotten a whole lot of recognition yet, Carter Clark, Cam's brother. Carter Clark's our director of hockey operations. He's a volunteer, does a lot of work for Adam Phillips and I regarding video and other stuff that maybe we don't want to do so much of. But we appreciate it, Carter. He's our eye in the sky behind the bench in the press box. And before the tournament, we came up with some hand signals, whether or not we should challenge plays or not. Basically, it was just a thumbs up or a thumbs down. I'm looking up for the thumbs up. And the play's still going on. And I can just see him up there scrambling. And on the computer trying to rewind or whatever he was doing. And there's a whistle down at the center. And I'm like, oh, shoot, hurry up. And the referee puts his hand up for our last change. And I called him over. I said, hey, was that not a head to the head? And he's like, I don't know, but you can challenge it. I said, okay. And I look up, and I think Carter got one look at it. Half of it. And he gave me the thumbs up, just like he knew there was no chance we weren't getting the call. And we challenged him, a 5-minute power play. We scored to make it 1-0. Had a little brain fart, and ended up 1-1 shortly after the same power play. And then we threw the group that scored the first power play out. They scored another one to go up 2-1. Big goal. Trevor Coikadal with the game winner the night before. Right, folks? Good forward check on that play by Matthew Redding. It was pretty neat. Coikadal gets rewarded with the goal. So we go 3-1. 3-1, we had a really good push in the second. Start the second period, then came Jefferson, a team that I thought does some really nice things. I think they beat us. They thought they were just going to have to throw pucks to the offensive zone and outrace us. They're a very fast team. I think maybe the only team all year that potentially outskated us at times. So their game plan was working a little bit, got us on our heels. Made it 3-2 going in the third. We knew there'd be another push in the third, and there was. But Cam Gray and our D stood tall, made a kill of 5-on-3, penalty kill. They never really had any great hits, and our guys did such a good job. Such a great job. And that's what I'd say about this group is when it came down to winning time, they did what they were supposed to do, and they did it perfectly. They executed, whether it was needing a big goal or a big penalty kill at the end. And then we get a little separation. Once again, Trevor Coikadal made a nice play behind the net, broke up a forecheck, and dumped it out front to Ryan Patosha, a freshman, the only freshman forward in the lineup, scores a big goal. I think at that time, we all felt like it was over, but we knew there's still work to do. But I'll never forget when Sam Ruffin put that empty netter in. And the sheer joy lives on that bench. And you're going to see a video in a couple of minutes, and I think that'll tell the story. One group of people I haven't thanked yet is the guys sitting behind me. The players, the coaching staff. You guys are special, and you know that. I love every one of you. The seniors that are taking off. Your legacy is set in stone. We talked about that before the game, didn't we? Today, two of our guys signed pro contracts. Rex Ball is going down to the football. Kind of already mentioned this, but seeing you guys hang out with my kids and dance and do the gritty. Continue to do that for us. All that stuff is pretty special to me. You guys will understand that one day when you're parents. And you will be soon, I promise. Enjoy it.
Before we invite you all down onto the ice, please direct your attention to the video board for a special video provided by Adrian College TV.
It's empty for Geneseo. 4-2 is our score. Geneseo wins the faceoff. Bulldogs take a shot. They score. The empty netter by Sam Ruffin. It's 5-2. Left of the game! Five to two is our score, Johnny!
Hey, Gibby, we're never gonna be the national champions!
Geneseo will hang on to it! 5 seconds left to go. 5, 3, the buzzer will sound. The Bulldogs, for the first time in program history, are the national champions! 31 wins, and it's no miracle. This is the best team in Division III. The Bulldogs win! National champions! There is an estate sale on the ice! 5-2 is the final score, and the Bulldogs win a national championship! Great season for Geneseo, but the Bulldogs reign supreme.
in a row in a national championship. Oh my gosh. Oh, how sweet it is.
Let's hear it one more time for the 2022 NCAA Division III.